Next up is number 16. That's too little of that song to hear. There we go, that was number 16. All right. Next up, number 17. For me, that is like, that's the American dream of a song.
It is.
That is. That could be like the third backup national anthem.
I love this song.
I love this song. I did it in a show once. There's a play and it popped up. That's why I have it in my collection. It's bizarrely not the only song that I have from that artist, though. That's strange. Okay, we're moving on next. Question. Write down the name of the song, write down the name of the artist. You guys just keep a tally in your heads of like how many you got in this last five. Okay, we've just got two questions left. Next up is number 19. Question number 19. Name the song and the artist. Anyone wants to sing that tonight, feel free. We have our final question, number 20. One more time, question number 20. That is all 20 questions, folks. Hopefully you've got 20 songs written down, 20. Wow, that's giving you a migraine. You're still thinking. You can do it. It's okay. You'll be all right.
I got it, thanks.
Yeah, you got it.
Nice. All right.
Now, what we're gonna do is we're gonna go through the answers. We're gonna mark your own papers. You're gonna grade them yourself. 1 point for each correct song, 1 point for each correct artist. We get to enjoy them a bit more as well. This one's question number one. It is Lionel Richie dancing on the ceiling.
This is the right song.
There we go. What a feeling there. Great. Dancing on the ceiling. Lionel Richie, number one. Number two. This one. Rebel, Rebel. David Bowie.
That was a big stretch.
Yeah, I knew.
That was a big stretch of the song. I knew it was Bowie.
I knew it was, that song I knew.
Rebel Rebel, Rebel Rebel, David Bowie there. Next up. This one is Spirit of Radio by Rush. Yes. Yeah. Got some Rush fans in?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Of course.
Yeah, nice. My fiance's uncle is in Rush. Yeah, plays the drums. It's pretty cool.
Fiance's uncle's Neil Peart?
Yeah.
Impressive.
I know, right? It's cool. I didn't know who Rush were when I first met her. She was like, oh, my uncle's in this movie. Yeah, you've seen the movie. I love
it.
My uncle's considered the greatest drummer of all time by most music fans. But yeah, it's cool. I've met him on FaceTime only. Which is
pretty cool.
It's cool. He's coming to the wedding, hopefully, you know.
That,
I hope so, because we've not booked a DJ.
That's hope to play.
Okay. Up next we have question number 4. Billy Joel, Tell Her About It. Yes, now you're up and running. All right. Feel free to sing some Billy Joel tonight as well, folks, at Crazy Karaoke. Up next, we have question number 5. It's Gangnam Style by Psy. I love the beginning, it sounds like it's coming from another room, it's so weird.
That I knew, darn it.
That was Gangnam Style by Psy. Up next we have number 6. This one, Beyonce, Halo. Halo by Beyonce. Point for the song, point for the artist, remember? Don't need to hear it, you just got me singing. Up next we have Huey Lewis and the News, Hip to Be Square. Yeah. Hip to Be Square, Huey Lewis and the News. Up next, Queen, I Want to Break Free. You didn't get that?
I got the wrong title.
That was only like 30 seconds of the song.
One.
You never had the song?
I got one. I got a Queen.
She's never heard this song before.
You've got to be kidding me.
That's such a good song. It's one of the most popular, famous Queen songs as well. It got banned in the US. Oh, I see.
That's right. He dressed like a
yeah,
lady.
Yeah, they just put on dresses and were doing the hoovering. The vacuum.
That's in the movie, that part.
Dude looks like a lady. He was dressed like a lady.
I've not seen the movie. I've not seen Bohemian Rhapsody yet.
Oh, you haven't?
No, I've not seen it.
Spoilers.
Yeah. I was working on here. Unfortunately, that's one of the things we don't own. One of the few things we don't own. Yet. I don't know. Do we own it now? No, in fact, is it not a Fox movie? We might own it. Who knows? Okay, up next we had Hall & Oates, You Make My Dreams. Yes, number 10. This one, Spirit in the Sky, Norman Greenbaum. It's a one-hit wonder. There's some quote that I can't exactly remember, but it basically implies that he got very lucky and he kind of admits that he has a very nice lifestyle and lots of nice things, all because he wrote one successful song, which is pretty cool. Okay, up next we have NSYNC.
Oh, I read the
It's Gonna Be Me. In the music video as well.
Then I wrote the Beatles. Then I wrote
Elf,
but it is the Beatles.
There we go. Up next we have Lucy in the Sky with Diamonds, the Beatles. There we go. That doesn't get banned, but dressing the dress and doing the vacuum does, I guess. Okay. Up next we had Closing Time, Semisonic. As you might say, Semisonic, I don't know, but Semi. It's a semi. Semi. Up next we had The Beach Boys, God Only Knows. You seen Love Actually? This is like the one at the end. And they're all coming back to the airport, and they're like, oh, you do have to watch it again. You should watch it at least once a month, Love Actually. No?
It's the opening song to that HBO show about the plural marriages.
Oh, really?
Big Love. Yeah, thank you.
There's an HBO show about plural marriages. Oh, okay.
Yeah. It's a good one.
It was good. Yeah, it, HBO, really. It does have everything.
Speaking of which, Game of Thrones! Not long now, April 14th, right? No one else cares that much. He's like, yeah, Game of Thrones, April 14th. Okay, up next we have The Bee Gees, More Than a Woman.
I'm not gonna win this one.
Probably not.
stop karaoke. People were walking past. That wasn't... Okay. Moving on to our next one we had. Oh, the next one was The Killers, Mr. Brightside.
That's why I said. It kind of starts, sounds like it, but it's not.
Okay. Mr. Brightside by The Killers there.
That's a nice.
Next up, this one. Oh. Glenn Campbell. Like a Rhinestone Cowboy. So low. This is, yeah.
Singing
it's
the same
ultimate
old song.
American dream song. It's great. It's such a good song. Up next, we have number 18. This was Justin Bieber.
Oh,
sound
like
the ultimate Canadian song. Sorry. Sorry, Justin Bieber. Sorry about Justin Bieber. I'm sorry on behalf of him. Up next, we have number 19. This was Elton John. I'm Still Standing. Question number 19. Oh, wow. Okay, we're nearly at the end now. Before I move on to question number 20, I want to tell you one of my favorite jokes of all time, but I need you to help out because it is a knock-knock joke. So, knock-knock.
Who's there?
Akeem.
Akeem who?
I came in like a wreck.
So what'd you get, 29?
Oh,
29.
A joke with production value is that. That's fun. Wrecking Ball, Miley Cyrus. So, out of those points, a maximum of 40 points.
You got next there.
We're going to find out
2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 13, 15, 17, 19, 21, 23, 25.
All right, so, yeah, I do love that joke, though. It's the first time someone told me, they didn't play me a version of the song. They just were like, knock, knock, who's there? Akeem who? And then they shouted, Akeem, you like it? Right in my face, and which is a really funny way to hear it. But what we're going to do right now is I'm going to come down and have a little, how many, you can't smoke that. Is it that good? I see, so it was obviously a high score.
Nine.
A high score.
That's not terrible.
Okay. We've got 9-14 and...
29.
29! 9-14 and 29. Well, congratulations
only
to our winning
players?
Team over here. I'll tell you what, because there was 4 of you that turned up for trivia, and I have 4 prizes. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to give your prize for you for turning up. A participation
Great job.
Prize. This is what the world has come to now, hasn't
awesome.
It? And there we go. You get your an extra one because you already won one earlier as well. So.
Thank you.
Everyone's a winner.
Congratulations. Give our winners a round
Love
of applause.
It.
Well done. That was
Woo!
Good work.
Good 29. Job, everybody.
I mean, that was literally more than the other 2 teams combined, so that's cool. Now, what's going to happen is in a few minutes, time, we're going to start with our crazy karaoke. Like I said before, we've got several of these crazy karaoke books. If you want to have a lot of inspiration, they're found just over there at the end
of
the
book. Crazy karaoke?
No.
We've got a long list and a short list, but we don't have every single thing from the database in those books because that would take forever to have a look through them.